one of a quick unheard story. Love it or hate it, you can't escape it. Yes, you're right. I'm sure all of you are thinking about dreading mathematics as a subject. But interestingly, we have the world's fastest human calculator here and the founder of Exploring Infinity is EduTech, Mr. Bhanu Prakash, who is here to share his unheard story of how did he race past the calculator.
Hello everyone, I'm Nilakanta Bhanu Prakash, and as you see, I'm the world's fastest human calculator. You might say, what is it about? Thanks a lot. You might say, what is it about? I'm going to quickly run you through it. Firstly, thanks a lot for having me here at Unheard Stories. Today, I'll be bringing out one narrative which I think every person who is a key decision maker in a school should hear. Every person who's driving an entire student force should understand, and every student out there can resonate with. Math is not fun. It hasn't been for a long, long time. It hasn't been for me either when I started off. I'm 21 now, and I'm going to quickly run you through my journey. You see a bunch of stuff which I've done in the past, have been recently featured in the BBC as the Usain Bolt of mathematics, and that's a lot of stuff by being congratulated by the President of India and addressing the Global Commonwealth Nations and being a part of a very recent celebration of promoting math as a culture through UNESCO. But I'm going to tell you where this all started, right? Because I was a regular school going kid too. A lot of you might have asked me, I recognize a lot of faces here in the audience. I know that you've seen me in the past in other conclaves and conferences. I was not born with this talent. I was a regular school going kid back born in 1999 in a middle class family where the idea of why mathematics is important is ingrained. How do you make it fun for you is not, right? It's about saying that maths chala important, you have to do it. Maths bahut important hai, kar lo. Par kaise kare, kya kare is never really told. So when I was 5, I met with an accident which changed my life entirely. This accident got me bedridden for an entire year, and I was not going to school, and I was alone. And being someone who was fascinated by what sports were, I didn't have a lot of stuff to do back home. So what do I do? My mom and dad introduced me to puzzles, something which I thought was a very friendly way to get acquainted because I was not even in a position to move. I could not get up. I was 5 years old. What do I do? So what looks like a tragedy was probably the seed to my success. And that's my first point, that you seek inspiration from almost everywhere and sometimes the baddest of your times. I started off by solving puzzles back then, and by the time I recovered and went back to school, I realized that puzzles and mental calculation were two things which really interested me. One thing which you might say is, why is mental calculation important or interesting? How can it be? And I would want to draw an analogy of how math was a sport to me. I started off by growing and understanding what such an inspiration Miss Shakuntala Devi Garu is. I'm sure how many of you have watched the video or the movie Prime Video, right? We have. She was a child hero, and I'm proud to say that a 5 year old back then, I'm not talking about Bhanu Prakash of today, I'm talking about a 5 year old back then who looked up to these puzzles or the books and said, this is something I want to do. Currently, I hold 4 world records which were once held by her. And I think I take a pride, and I don't say it as a matter of, say, me overtaking someone, but I think the inspiration drawn by a 5 year old is extremely important. And several times, it never is math. I have become the world's fastest human calculator. The journey was about understanding myself, understanding what math means, because, come on, for all the principals here, all the teachers here, and all the students here, math is just about doing a bunch of things which we barely apply. Or yes, if you talk about application, we talk about its application in science, technology, engineering, but not something which develops an individual. I'm speaking at a forum where I think entrepreneurship is being stressed a lot. I have currently, until now, headed two startups, one with a major exit, and there is Exploring Infinity, is a stall on the backside, which is the math education startup which I head, which has been addressed and has featured in extremely big light across the world. I would say that math is not just about learning or doing a bunch of things. It's about training your brain. It's about training your brain in a certain capacity. And before I become abstract now and you don't relate to what I do, I'm going to quickly do a bunch of calculations to show you guys what I mean, right? Because I think that makes more sense. I'll probably have one person in the crowd probably volunteer. Yeah? Anyone? Sure. Anyone with a calculator, actually. It'll be great if you can pass on the mic to literally anyone. Yeah, yeah. So, yeah.
Bring it on.
Sure. I'm going to tell you what we can do, ma'am. So, yeah. Ideally, give the calculator to someone else because there's usually a mishap. So, yeah. Ma'am, what I want you to do is to give me a two-digit number. I will say plus. You give me another two-digit number. I will say plus, and we'll go back and forth until you get tired. Right? Sure.
Okay.
Go ahead.
25.
Plus?
39.
Plus?
All two-digit numbers?
You can, I mean, it doesn't really have to be, but I'm gonna slowly increase the pace of what we do. So I'm gonna do a 10-digit number later. But yeah, 25 plus 39?
82.
Plus?
96.
Plus?
43.
Plus?
68.
Plus?
29.
Plus?
12.
Okay. The answer is 394, if you've checked, right? Thanks a lot, ma'am. Since I've been told that there's not a lot of time, I'm going to quickly run through. I'm going to showcase a world record which I hold right now. What I want you to do is, anyone here who has a calculator, open it. I'm going to tell you what to do. Thanks a lot for the number. What ma'am has told me, the question was discrete, right? There's a lot of time gap between her telling me a question, me saying, okay. I have a lot of leeway, right? So type in 83 in your calculator, all of you. You do? Plus 83. How much do you get? A 166? Yes, everyone? Give me an I. Yes. Yeah. Plus 83. You get a 249? Yeah? You keep doing that, and I'm going to try racing past you. All right? 83. 166. 249. 332. 415. 498. 581. 664, 747, 830, 913, 996, 1079, 1162, 1245, 1328, 1411, 1494, 1577, 1660, 1743, 1826, 1909, 1992, 2075, 2158, 2241, 2324, 2407, 2490. I can keep talking to you and I'm doing it. Okay, yeah. I'm at 3320, 3340, 3348, 6356, 3652. And what you've seen here is not magic. I've not done a square root. I've not done a multiplication. I've not done a division, only because of the fact that they can have shortcuts, right? So I'm going to quickly make my first difference here. In my journey, and I've understood that proving yourself by doing something quickly through a shortcut doesn't make you an efficient person. And that's the reason why I take the most mundane of things. I'm going to circle back to it, but if you can change to the other tab here. What we have on the screen, since ma'am was telling me a bunch of numbers, I had a lot of leeway. This screen is going to be throwing numbers at me as quickly as it can. It's a computer. A number and a number are differentiated with 0.5 seconds. So there's less than a second for every number there. And you can start off, and I'm going to try adding them all. And I'm going to speak out loud to show how I think here. 3, 2, 1, go. 11, 29. 88, 149, 176, 261, 354, 447, 531, 625. 625. You can check it if you can. That's a correct one. Double the speed there, or triple it if you can, I'm not sure. Make that 200, and this 300, the 300. And make that 15 on the top, yeah. 15, no, the second one. Yeah, the 15. So what I have here, guys, is I'm actually attempting something which is called impossible according to a lot of cognitive ability studies, right? A human brain cannot do more than 16 calculations per second. Have you ever thought of it? Have you ever heard of it? 16 frames per second is what people can see. It's not more than that. So what I'm going to try is I'm going to try adding them all up, and I'm going to try doing it. I just want you to even see the numbers. They're going to go away as quickly as possible. So I'm not going to speak out loud because that will slow me down. All right? 3, 2, 1, go. $768. Is that correct? Absolutely. Right? Now, circle back. What I'm showing you is that the brain is capable of doing the impossible. Things like these, which have never been done before. What I've shown you here is my stage attempt. Obviously, I don't want to go wrong, right? So I do twice as quick as this. I just don't want to go wrong in front of you. So I'm not doing it at my best speed. But what I wanted to tell you is that every child is capable of doing this. And if you can go back to the presentation, every child is capable of doing this. Every student, every person, but not via teaching them Abacus, not by teaching them trickery, not by teaching them stuff like, hey, if you want to do a 25 square, you take 2, multiply by 3, you get 6, put the 25 next to it, it's 625. How many of you heard of this? A lot of you have, right? It's a good thing to know. Doesn't help you in life, right? The reason is it's like saying this: I can run a 100 meter race provided I have skates, which is a huge condition to make. There's no shortcut. It's like saying that I'm going to be a huge entrepreneur, make my company's valuation $1 billion, but give me 500 million as my capital. It's as good as that. It's about saying that what are the prerequisites which you need. Bootstrap your intelligence, bootstrap your cognitive ability development, bootstrap your learning. I think that's what I would say. Before I continue and show you a bunch of other things here. Picture seems very familiar. 3 kids running away. 1 kid who actually knows math being with the ghost and scaring these people away. Something which happens in every school, in every enterprise, in every startup, in every single organization I've ever been a part of. Trust me, I have mentored more than 1,500 startups and their founders who are scared of their balance sheets, who are scared to put numbers in their Excel because of the fact that they don't come from math backgrounds, because of the fact that they think that it's something very, very difficult to achieve. 3 out of every 4 students are math phobic. And you're going to see a bunch of things, stats. That's how many students today in schools of India who are actually studying math. 25 crore, 250 million with the 7 zeros. Out of which, if you see, that's around 75%. Cannot do this. Do not understand what this means. And these children, you might think, okay, these people are from underprivileged schools. These people are from government schools. Not really. I'm not going to take the names, but studies have been conducted on huge schools in India. Huge schools in Hyderabad, one of the top 10 on the Times list. And we have seen that kids of 9th grade cannot do this. They cannot do this without the help of a calculator. They do get good marks in their exams. They go through it. They take SATs and move on, but they do not know what this means. Over 10 crore children do not know that 4 into 3 is 3 into 4 and that it means 4 plus 4 plus 4. They know it's 12. Because 4 threes are 12. That's what we've been taught all along. And I'm going to continue on saying that the first part of whatever I've shown you is just a flavor to make you guys listen to me, right? I'm going to take the next 5 minutes to end on what it is, because I don't want to waste a lot of time, and short speeches are most impactful at times. My journey began with me being the fastest human calculator. That's a head start I've gotten. Temple Run, if you've played back in my times, that was the game. You click the head start, you go a little forward, right? That's what it was. But it has not begun entirely, because I see that the purpose is to make every child actually love math. You might say, okay, I'm going to make them do Abacus. I'm going to make them do Vedic math. I'm going to make them crack exams. In none of these, you've concentrated or truly looked about saying that how can they love math or why is it important, right? Now, continuing from here, I would say that, see, this is a quick, I think since it's unheard stories, and I think I would probably want to say a small story here, which everyone would know. In HICC, the same place which we are at right now, 4 years ago, I was invited to a speech. And I was addressing around 100 school principals. I was a student addressing stuff and saying that this is what I know. That day, I wanted to create a logo to say that this is what I want to start in my future, right? So this is where I've presented something called Exploring Infinities, a logo with no registration, with nothing. And I started off saying that this is my vision ahead. I have my teammates who were there on that day as well with me. My journey from there has begun into changing the way people look at math, and I'm going to give you quick stats. Exploring Infinities was something which I started off a couple of years ago, extensively. We are present in over 7 countries as of now, and we are impacting the lives of over a million students, directly, not indirectly through any other medium. And how is that? Is by making them understand math from the truest format. Questions which I think you need to ask. I'm going to ask you 3 to 4 questions, and I'm going to quickly run through this. Why does the number 10 come after number 9? Good question to ask. What is the historical relevance of numbers? Why do we have to count? Good answer. I think we'll get to the answers a little later, right? Cool. I just want to leave it. I'm sure you do. Great talk before, by the way. So I would say that making children curious about math and the way they do it, making them empowered to say that they can actually achieve this, is exactly how it works. There's no other shortcut to this. There's no way where you can teach whatever is in your books to make it interesting for them. It's about asking why negative numbers exist. It's about giving them limited information, enough to make them curious, not enough to make them not appreciate the art of whatever it is. And I'm going to continue here and quickly run through. Why did we start it? Because for me, math was a fun-loving experience. And I hope that it's the same for everyone. And I've already talked about this. You see here, there are 3 things which I would probably want to end the conversation with before I open up for any, I think, power, if there are a couple of questions which I think I'll open out for later. But I believe that math or numbers have developed me or anyone I've known in the right way as an individual. It's not about being able to do your problems. It's about quantitatively analyzing stuff. I'm looking at you guys right now. I can say I'm looking at a lot of people. If I say I'm looking at 126 people, that's when I'm being absolute, right? So the absoluteness of the world lies in it. It's a double-edged sword. Language and numbers go together. And that's the reason why I today would take this as an opportunity to ask every leader in the school education system today to make the move not towards better grades. I'm sorry to tell you, that never works. Towards giving your students an experience of loving mathematics, on asking the whys, because I'm gonna actually be a little aggressive on a bunch of stuff before. This is how we have modeled or whatever. The 2 people on the screen. One says, I can do calculations with trick and shortcuts. The other says that I can do calculations because I truly understand what math is. The child there says, I can create drag and drop apps. Notice the color of the hat which he's wearing. And let's go here and talk about, I hope someone got that pun. But anyway, so there is the other thing which says that I really understand the math behind AI and ML because it's not about dragging and dropping apps into creating what we call K-12 camps or juniors wearing white hats. We don't really want this to happen. And I hope every single person really, thanks for the hoot, I really, really want every one of you to sincerely understand that if you want to write a book, you cannot learn alphabet for 25 years. It doesn't just help. A, B, C, D, if, while, for, okay, drag and drop AR, that doesn't work. I'm probably being a little aggressive here, but sincerely, stop moving towards making something which, see, skills like entrepreneurship, skills like math, skills like communication, skills like English, things like language, These are what you need to invest in. And I would request every one of you, probably before I close here, to see that there is a small kiosk put there of Exploring Infinities. Go have a conversation on what experiential math learning is. Saying that, I would want to say and conclude that our students, and when I say our, it's Exploring Infinities or any other organization, have shown exceptional academic improvement. That's not a goal. We have grown out of math phobia and have become 4 times quicker and better at stuff. So this is the kiosk you see on the top end. And I would probably end saying that let's make every child learn math the right way. And the right way is far beyond what you think is the right way. And I want every one of you to truly realize that. Thanks a lot.